you're at camp.
I can't believe that.
Neither can I. Yeah, that's a long time.
Can't believe that.
That's a long time, huh? Do you have anything you want to tell them? Do you have any funny stories that you remember about Uncle Ted or Aunt Judy?
Remember last year he hung his fucking shorts up in the hangar on the what?
Up the flagpole.
He
hung his shorts up the flagpole.
Funny story.
Okay, let's hear it.
I know Ted. They always have goofy around, like, the crazy, it's like they're crazy. No, 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 it's like, and Maggie, Maggie's uncle. Oh, like, and stuff, like, it's like a Maggie, it's like a bear, it's like an alien, like, every stuff, like, also, I have Ted, or something like that, like, I just wanted Ted to be nice.
What do you like the most about Ted or Judy?
I talk to them on the phone.
Do you? When do you call them?
Like on Fridays.
On Fridays, and they always talk to you?
Yeah.
What do you guys talk about?
About work.
What do they do that's funny at camp?
Put water. Don't even put bucket of water after Ted's chilling.
He's good, good sport, awesome person.
What about Aunt Judy?
Good, nice, fun to be around.
She's the one who sent me and Jessica bowling up.
Uh-huh, how did she do that?
She said, Jessica, you make a cute couple.
And you guys just thought, yeah, we do.
And that's who said, put that idea in our head.
That's so funny. Got you and Jessica together, huh? And how long have you two been together?
9 years!
Nine years?
Teach courses. Pretty cool. Smart. Pay some. Pretty cool. Courses.
They're nice. They're caring. They're super.
What do you like about Uncle Ted?
Uncle Ted's this great guy.
What about Aunt Judy?
This great lady.
What do you think about Judy?
She's a nice lady.
Nice lady?
Yes, she is.
Uncle Ted.
Ted is a handsome man.
He's a handsome man.
Yes.
You're moving in on Ted now. We're going to have to tell Aunt Judy about you. He's nice to talk to, hang around.
Yeah, he is. I like Judy up his head here.
Yeah? You look forward to coming down here?
Yeah.
What about Uncle Ted? What's your favorite thing about Uncle Ted?
That he's the best guy. He's always the best guy there is because they can't do the whole camp park without him.
He's a very nice person, very nice to help us a good bit. She did good to help us.
Yeah?
Very much.
What about Ted?
Ted did good. He did good because he's a fun guy, because he makes me laugh so hard. He makes people laugh.
I love you to this day.
I can't believe how Uncle Ted and Aunt Judy have been able to do this for 50 years. I've only been here for a very short time. It's a lot to do, but it is amazing, and it keeps me coming back every year.
My earliest camp memory of Ted and Judy might not have actually taken place here at Laurel Hill State Park. I think it was probably painting in their driveway when I was a really small child. We use scene setters now, or we have Aunt Teen and Uncle Chad to put together these incredible backdrops. But back in the day, 30 years ago, we used to use cardboard and paint everything. And so, I mean, there would just be marathon sessions. And I think storing stuff in their basement and, you know, just painting in their yard and their driveway and all through their house, that's what I remember.
My favorite memories about Aunt Judy specifically is whenever I was a babysat kid and my dad was a senior counselor, Judy would always say, "Now remember, this isn't a vacation for you. It's about the campers." You know, at the carnival, I remember coming up, and we could win the prizes, but we weren't allowed to win coins because it wasn't about us. It was about the campers. And from even at a young age, she really instilled the idea of putting others before yourself.
I grew up in the North Star School District, so Uncle Ted was actually my teacher. So I remember coming to Camp Park and being afraid of him. But now Uncle Ted is very supportive. And he is like my uncle.
I think the most thing that got me was the family tie, like the aunt-uncle thing is, we say we do it for the campers. But I really feel that everybody that comes to camp feels like it's family. And, you know, we know that it's not really my aunt, but I think everybody feels like they have that relationship.
Ted and Judy have had a really positive influence, not just on me, but on my whole family. Known them probably over 25 years now, and my husband was involved, his family was involved. We had to move away, but then our kids were intrigued by the experience of working with kids that had special needs, and it's become a family affair for us and a lifelong love of working with kids that it's not something we instilled, it's something that Ted and Judy gave our family, and then hopefully we can turn around and share this with other people.
They've created such a family up here that it's been more than a family tradition, it's been inspirational and something that I wanted to bring my family here. So the ability to share this with my children and have them experience the same kind of things that I grew up doing. You know, it teaches so much about compassion and tolerance that you cannot otherwise learn out there in the real world, as Uncle Ted likes to call it.
Judy, I really respect them and how they know each and every camper. Like, they know exactly what makes them tick and how to get them to do certain things.
They just showed me like how I could do different things to get the camper to be happier, so they weren't so upset. So I guess what I learned from them is to be a different, they use different techniques with each camper.
They've influenced me that I want to go into special education and do this kind of thing.
I don't know where to start with funny stories. The most obvious thing with Uncle Ted would be the simple fact that I'm sure you've heard this 100 times. I have seen him sleep in every conceivable position, chair, bench, stump, ground, standing up almost.
In the middle of a meeting, he would stand up on the picnic table to talk to all of us. And they've got those, like, the extension bars, whatever, the tension bar going around, and he'd stick his hands up on the tension bars, and then he'd lean his head, and he's standing the whole time, falling asleep while talking to us.
I've ever seen was, he was up actually just this year, is underneath the tent, and it was mini week for the little ones, and he's sitting on a chair, the big glowing balls out underneath, and he's just slumped over in a chair, and it has to be like 2 a.m.
Sweet moment. I remember one year, Ted and Judy leaning on each other, sitting outside after a meeting, just because, no, it was before a meeting, and we were all waiting there, but they were passed out. So it's Camp Park romance.
I like where we start something 2.5 hours late, but we have a big show, and Judy just gets up on stage and laughs it off, and no one really cares because they're having a great time.
I always enjoy watching Ted walk down to the beach
He just seems really relaxed and enjoys that time with the campers. And with Judy, I don't know, I think my favorite thing about Judy is when she sits down and relaxes and just laughs with the rest of the senior staff.
The running gag forever has always been, what color are we wearing today? Because it always seems like at 8 o'clock in the morning, Aunt Judy's always like one color behind. she's taken a lot of heat over that over the years. Everybody's in blue and she's doing green or whatever. But yeah, when I think of Aunt Judy, she's probably taken a lot of heat on it. Probably the time that they surprised her with the spider song. It's a song that came back out of the archives from a long time ago, and she had no idea that that thing was coming. And that's sort of been a running gag over the years also. They've kind of reincarnated that.
Whenever Judy did Spider on My Head, because Aunt Judy was always a pretty serious person in school, and then to come to camp and see her doing an act like that, and all the campers loved it, was just really awesome to see that side of her.
Spider on the floor, 4 inches.
She doesn't not like spiders.
He don't like spiders. Aunt Judy don't like spiders.
The bug.
The bug?
She laughed about the bug.
You mean the spider song?
Yeah. She laughed at us.
I like her jumping up and down with that spider song.
Yeah, that.
I just want to tell them how much I love them and I enjoy coming up here to Camp Park every year.
Some brightly burning, some dark and cold. There is a spirit who brings a fire, ignites a candle, and makes his home. So carry. Seek out the hopeless, confused and torn, and hold out your candle for all to see it. Take your candle and go light your world. Take your candle and go light your world.
Happy anniversary! I'm Superman!
I miss you guys, and I always miss you guys. Because I love you.